Happy Thursday. Phil Lindemann with your midday news on Krystal 93. A fatal wreck closed I-70 for more than 13 hours yesterday between Silverthorne and Loveland as crews cleaned up a burnt-out semi-truck and investigated what happened. The 43-year-old trucker from California died on scene. Four other vehicles were involved, including one driven by a CDOT employee who suffered serious injuries. Yesterday's closure led to major backups on Loveland Pass and US 6 through Dillon. More progress on the Ptarmigan Fire, now 75% contained. The Forest Service confirms it was sparked by people, but they have no suspects. An investigation is ongoing. A new project on Monarch Pass is trying to make cash off wildfire mitigation. This from the Colorado Sun. For-profit lumber yards are joining up with nonprofit conservationists to thin dead and dying trees. They know the Forest Service can't afford to do it on their own, and local businesses like Monarch Ski Area cannot afford a devastating wildfire. They are hoping this public-private partnership becomes a model for more projects statewide. 90% of trees at Monarch Pass are beetle kill, which is very similar to right here in Summit. Today at 5:30, Summit County is hosting the first of two public meetings to answer your questions about new short-term rental rules, like the difference between resort and neighborhood zones, and who qualifies for one of three license types. That meeting starts at 5:30 p.m. at the Silverthorne Library. A second meeting is next Thursday, October 14th, same time, in Breck. The effort to recall the mayor of Grand Lake has failed. Sky High News reports Mayor Steve Coudron gets to keep his position by a huge margin, 150 to 45. A small but vocal group of locals demanded the recall after Coudron made decisions about housing and budgeting they found irresponsible. An injured hiker on Guanella Pass got an assist from Good Samaritans armed with belts, shoelaces, and tree branches. Nine News reports the 77-year-old man was hiking above Georgetown when he fell, injuring his arm. He was bleeding and nearly hypothermic when five hikers found him and created a makeshift gurney. They carried him a half mile down the trail before paramedics arrived. Search and rescue is free for lost or injured hikers, skiers, and more in Colorado. But that's not the case everywhere. This from the New York Times. Six states, including Oregon and Idaho, can charge victims for rescue. Sometimes the bill is in the tens of thousands of dollars, which is why pros in Colorado say it is not a good fit. Anna DeBatiste of the Colorado Search and Rescue Association tells the Times, "We know from experience that people who think they are going to get charged delay calling, and that can have more serious or sometimes deadly consequences." Silverthorne's First Friday last week raised nearly $26,000 for local nonprofits. The Free Beer, Wine, and Liquor Festival was another big success, drawing hundreds of people to support five local nonprofits like Summit Advocates and The Smurf. In sports, the Nuggets lost to the Warriors last night, 118-116. Today, the Avalanche played the Stars at 6. And in local sports, Summit High Boys Soccer is playing Vail Mountain School at home today. Phil Lindemann, Krystal 93 News.